Who are you?
Hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI. I can hear you.
Cauldron Lake.
Yes, I'm at Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm in danger. The dark presence.
Danger. Thanks. Got it. Are you okay?
No! No! It's my fault! It got out with my face! Scratch!
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
He's changed the story. The dark presence. We must stop it before...
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
And I don't need to hide. My foolish pride paid the price. I will never leave again. I'm by your side. I was calling you. Did you hear me? I lost my way. Lost my way.
Anderson, where did you go? All of a sudden, the radio stopped working, and then the flooding just disappeared. Crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Alex Casey, how? Am I still... Is this the dark place? No, it can't be. I got out.
Yeah, the PI from your books has the same name as me. Great. Moving on. It's a bit of a hike to the car, Wake. Get your bearings, then we'll head out.
I need another minute. Colin,
should look around. I thought I'd never see. With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. The flooding disappeared very suddenly. I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap, to Nightingale.
Keep an eye out for them.
Okay. Okay, just give me a moment. It's okay.
Take your time.
A creepy twig sculpture? A locked box. Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it? Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade. The cult doesn't see their victims as people.
He'd been on the trail of the writer forever. The writer he despised. Hemingway, Bukowski, Wake. I'll get you. I'll find you. I'll make you pay. You're in over your head. He descended into the tunnels from the Dark City, into the ocean of darkness. Next stop, Caldera Street Station. Something, a presence, rumbled. Not a train. Shadows shifted on the platform. The Rider's cult waited for him there. The cult of the word. A cultist leaned close. I carry his words close to my chest now. You're not allowed in the lake until he says otherwise. He'd be caught. Murdered. They got him. They didn't get him. He was reborn out of hate. He was there. But he was risen. Sent to find the light switch up from the lake that was not the lake.
Out on the case board. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. After I stop Nightingale, a writer who's also been missing for 13 years turns up. What's the connection? What kind of case is this?
Thank you.
pasteboard. Is leaving supplies around for themselves. Wonder what's inside. I should take a look around for a way to open this thing.
Back at Witch's Ladle, Saga pointed the flashlight at the strange, dark substance. The same substance Nightingale had left at the morgue. There was something hidden under it. She strained to see, the opposite of sunspots in her eyes, blacker than black. Suddenly a change. The light reacted to the substance, a feedback loop surging up her arm. Saga squeezed the flashlight, willing it to penetrate the dark matter. Burn it away.
There's something written here. A poem? Or a riddle? Reminds me of the nursery rhymes I read to Logan when she was little. A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan. Something feels different. I should look around. A charm. Cute. It'll go great on the bracelet Logan made for me. Huh. That was strange. Gotta keep an eye out for more of these rhymes. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. After I stop Nightingale, a rider who's also been missing for 13 years turns up. What's the connection? What kind of case is this? Creepy dolls, mysterious rhymes. No weirder than anything else going on, I guess. Nope. Finding a Casey movie lunchbox out here can't be a coincidence. Another message? Ah, can't forget the dolls. Might need them again.
Watching the net.
another one of those rhymes.
Children in Bright Falls all grew up hearing stories about the cult of the tree. Feral maniacs living in the woods. Satanists chanting, "We watch in the night," as they perform blood sacrifices in the forests. Or things not quite human lurking in the dark. There were many versions of the story, but they all shared one important element. Danger in the dark, in the woods. Somewhere among all the urban legends lay a secret truth. The real identity of the cultists prowling in the woods. Real faces hid behind the masks. Real hands held the knives. Real people fulfilling a grim purpose. The forest was not safe. People were right to keep their children away from the trees.
Another locked box. there's a rhyme over here. Hey there, Mr. Deer. You remind me of a dream I had. Nah. A weird feeling something's changed. What is this? Jesus. Another charm for my bracelet. Miss you, kiddo. I'll be home soon. If only the rest of the Bureau knew what a softy Casey is.
An overlap of the Dark Place needed a push from both directions to manifest itself. Reality in our world eroded by repeated Dark Lore tied to a location and a counterpoint. A work of art, a horror narrative crafted in the depths of the Dark Place, connecting to the story on the other side to reach out through the weakened veil. A story of a lawman whose heart was cut out of his chest. Two corrupt men killed by their own twisted ambition. A haunted old woman drowned in a bathtub. Twisted reflections on the other side of the mirror. arcs stabbing through realities, amplifying the influence of the dark place. These elements working in conjunction made a trickle that became a torrent, a wormhole, a vortex, and the art, the map, became the nightmare territory where the dark place encroached on our reality, a blanket over it, where they all overlapped, causing reality to twist and loop like a bad dream, remolding anything and anyone within its dark horror design.
We've reached the car, Anderson. How's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot. Keep trying. Hmm. Right.
Purpose! Activity detected. AWE. Event in progress. Cauldron Lake. What's an AWE? Casey, what exactly does the FBC do?
After New York, when I started looking for our friend here, their name came up. I pushed them for any files they had on him, but got stonewalled. They have a reputation of showing up for weird shit. They have a presence here, and now we find our writer. How about that?
Ready to go?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Mom, before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's, just a weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Wanna say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now. Is there anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense.
I remember.
Waking up in places with no memory of how I'd gotten there. It was out of control. I didn't need another mugshot in the fucking tabloids.
Good to see you, Alan. This must be an exciting time for you. Tell me, does it ever get old?
Sorry, does what get old?
Publishing a new book. Are you okay there, my friend? You look like you've been cooped up in the writer's room for a few too many years.
This is exactly how I feel.
You know, I've waited so long to get my hands on the sequel to Departure. You left us on quite the cliffhanger. We've all been dying to know what "it's not a lake, it's an ocean" really means.
You and me both.
Well, our wait is over. Your new book, Initiation, hits the shelves tomorrow.
What?
That's exactly what every reader will be asking. This book is mind-bending. It's so cerebral. I mean, how would you describe it? An auto-fictional thought experiment? A horror story? Postmodern detective story?
Wait. This isn't right. I haven't written anything.
He's so humble.
Okay, you got me. Good prank, very funny. But yeah, sad to say, I've not written this. I'd remember if I'd written a book, right?
Or maybe it was written by your evil double. Well played, man! That is spot on! Playing the role here! Pretending the world of the book overlaps our own? That's very meta indeed. You see, Initiation tells the story of a fictional writer named Alan Wake, who is trapped in a nightmare, desperately trying to find the manuscript of a novel he has forgotten he has written. The book is set in New York, but it might not be New York at all. He is tormented by his dark doppelganger, and guided by visions of a fictional detective he has written. That's right, Alex Casey is in this book as well.
I guess we'll just keep doing this the whole show. The joke's on me.
But isn't that what you sign up for with autofiction? No, but seriously, I found the structure of the reality you build in the book fascinating. It reminded me of The Matrix. I mean, the writer is physically in his writer's room, trapped there, and he projects himself out to this dark dream of New York through the story he is writing. Like astral projection. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Go on. I should be taking notes here. This is great stuff.
Notes to that other Alan Wake in that room writing this as we speak? Are we all in your story, Alan? Wow. No, I wish you every success with your new book, Alan. I hope it's as successful as your best-selling Alex Casey series. Initiation hits the shelves tomorrow. After this, I'm sure we'll all be eagerly awaiting the culmination of this hero's journey trilogy of yours. A book called Return, perhaps.
Man,
thank you for one of the strangest interviews of my entire career, Alan. All this talk of meta-narratives. I'm expecting to disappear once this scene ends.
Hello?
I'm losing it.
Something's not right here.
I needed to get home. To Alice. What the hell was that interview? Some kind of joke? Initiation? I never wrote a book called Initiation.
This felt like a bad dream. Could make a good horror story.
Gods of Asgard. That name sounded familiar. I was a mess. I'd never heard of this talk show or Mr. Door before. None of it felt right. Was I losing my mind? There was something here. A broken transmission I couldn't quite make out. What was that? A message? Oh, impossible to say.
nightmare, I felt like a drowning man gasping for air. This place felt familiar. A ghost of a memory surfaced, about riding here for countless days. I had been writing. Initiation. You must write to escape. A plot board for mapping out a story. On the index cards, the nightmare that just happened to me. A summary of the story so far. But other notes as well. Warnings. I had written them. I couldn't remember what it all meant. The name Scratch filled me with dread. I could trust these words. I had to act on them. You must write to escape.
In the film series. And of course, we have Alan Wake here, the best-selling writer the books, the films are based on. Let's do this!
Welcome back to the show. So, Alan, as the creator of the character, how do you feel about this?
Sorry, what?
I know it can be an awkward question with the man sitting right next to you, but I mean, how do you feel about him in the role of Casey? Does he look the part to you?
He looks exactly like I always imagined Casey to be. It's uncanny.
Thank you. That means so much to me. I'm a huge fan of your books.
So, what's the problem, Alan? Because on more than one occasion, you voiced your reservations about the adaptations.
It's not that. They're their own thing. They've gone with choices that are different from mine. I feel protective about my stories, and these adaptations... I don't know. I guess I just wish I could have been more involved in making them.
Well, in that case, you won't have seen this either. We have a clip from the new film, Murder Case Casey. Should we roll it, or do you want to say something first, Sam?
Nah, just roll it.
This city was an old scar that refused to heal. The rain made it fester. It needed the sun, but there was only the night. I was tired. Insomnia covered me like a plastic film. I was watching the world through a rain-slick window, my own reflection haunting the view. I was trying to track down a missing writer. My only clue was a table lamp shaped like an angel, the only thing to shed light on this sordid mystery.
That's great! Murder case, Casey! Great job, Sam! Very exciting and very meta. I'm looking forward to seeing more.
Wait, stop. What was that about a writer? About a lamp? Hello?
Oh, not so much evil that not a bit of good as well. Not one without the other. Good to see you.
Hey, I can't seem to find my way out of here. Can you point me to the exit?
Totta helvetissä. Of course, Tom. The work will instruct its maker. I was gonna get something from the basement for you, but you can get it yourself now. The more cooks, the worse the soup.
Have we met before? Are you trapped in the dark place too?
You remember Ahti, the janitor. You can't be lost if you don't worry about where you are headed. So don't worry, Tom. The sun will shine even into a heap of twigs. Just remember to turn on the lights. It won't take long when you get to work.
What do you want me to get from the basement? And my name's Alan, not Tom.
Yeah, but katsoppa, kun a man, but a man with a tool makes two, Tom. Eikö niin? And a man with a tool can build his own exit. It's in a shoebox, in the basement where you left it. Safe as in the Lord's purse. Here's the key.
I've been trying to find a way to escape the dark place. Any suggestions?
He who mouths about his troubles is the prisoner of his troubles. It's not easy to get out. But don't you worry, Tom. The home is still there where the heart is. I often think about it when I mop the floor and look into the puddle. Water is the memory of the world. Water finds its way.
The janitor was a bit out there, but still a friendly face. I had to trust the basement would get me out of here. An old lamp and a shoebox. Was this what the janitor had left for me? The lamp felt significant. A tool for bringing light to the darkness. I
felt a magnetic pull between the lamp and the light overhead.
Whoa!
When the light jumped into my lamp, the whole room changed, like something in a dream. Opening a way forward, the lamp was humming. The bulb glowed. It held the light now. I felt another surge from the lamp. I could use it if the glow in the lamp went out, shifting the light in the room. The light carved out something new from the darkness. Place wants to drown me. I'm losing myself. I have to fight it. I have to remember the clicker, the light switch. I lost it, but I have the lamp now. The lamp the switch was cut from. This place is a nightmare. Not real, and yet more real than anything. The danger and the horror are real. It feeds off my mind, twisting whatever it takes into psychotic reality. I'm trapped here. I write to escape. I've tried this many times, written countless stories, forgotten how many. I keep failing, but I must keep trying. I use the story to dive deeper. Every word I write is a step forward on this spiral of the darkness. I dive to the body to find the answer, the map, and the key, and the compass. It's combined to form a door leading out. But how do you open a door that's not a door? At the bottom of an ocean, that's not an ocean, and a lake. That's not a lake.
To this trap, this trap.